Now, I'm going to give you five reasons why I believe a mirrorless camera is the better way to go over DSLR, especially in 2020. So I won't go into too much detail for each one, but it sort of gives you a general idea and gets you thinking. You can do your own research, because at the end of the day, you should never go based off someone's or buy something off someone's pure recommendation. You should always look into yourself and make your own independent decision of what you want to buy. So reason one is you see what you get. What I mean by this is with the EVF. When you look for an EVF, it's giving you like an LCD display that shows you what the exposure will look like using exposure simulation. Now, this is the same as when you use a DSLR with the rear screen, except because you can hold it up to your eye with the EVF, it's obviously a lot more stabler. You can review photos in there, and if you're in bright light, it can make it a lot easier to look to make sure you have got the exposure right and not too bright, not too dark, all that sort of stuff. Can even be easier and more detailed to actually zoom in and punch into like what 5 times, 10 times to make sure you've actually nailed focus as well. Now, when it comes to this point, it may not seem like a good thing for experienced photographers, but it is still. But especially if you're a beginner and you're still learning the exposure triangle, rather than take a photo, chimp to see if you got it right. And if people don't know what chimping is, it's sort of like looking at the back screen in a certain way, like the way a monkey would look at the screen, doing that and then constantly taking photos over and over again. You know, as a beginner, it could be frustrating. You might feel like it's too hard or too much hassle, and you may end up giving up the hobby before you even get the chance to get started. Whereas with a mirrorless camera, you're seeing exactly what you get from the start when you're looking through that viewfinder. So you can focus more on your composition, what's in your background, everything, your colors, lighting, exposure. You can focus on all that. You don't really have to worry about the guesswork of it. Because of this, you're more likely to get usable shots, and you can enjoy it more, and learn faster, and have a lot more of a fun time while shooting. Even for people who are existing photographers and looking to get their next camera body, you may be put off by the fact that, you know, you prefer an OVF. I liked optical viewfinders before as well, but I easily adjusted to an EVF. I've gotten to the point now where I like it much better. I would feel lost without it. All the information you can get in the viewfinder when it comes to your focus peaking, your leveler, your histogram to show you, you know, making sure you haven't blown any highlights or anything like that. There's so much more information you can get through the viewfinder. So that's one of the main and biggest reasons you should and want to get a mirrorless camera. Reason two would be the larger focus area. So as you know, with any DSLR, aside from the high-end ones like your Nikon 1DX Mark whatever, your Nikon D5, D6, that sort of thing, when you look through the viewfinder, you have a set area of where the focus spots are. Now, depending on what camera you have, for example, you know, you have a 1DX, you might have 100 focus points spread out a bit more. Whereas with something cheaper, like your Rebel cameras and 80D, that kind of thing, you're still going to have a decent amount, but they're more clustered in the center. So if you want to, say, have your focus or your subject that you're focusing on really far out to the frame, you got two options on the DSLR, three options kind of. Number one, manual focus, which can be hard, especially if your eyesight isn't the best. I have okay eyesight, but I'm horrible at manual focus, and I always have been, even when I use the matte focusing screen back on my 60. Your second option would be focus and recompose. So what you do is you use the focus point, gain focus, and then move it, the framing, to what you want. This does work, and a lot of people used to use focus recompose, but as you do it, you may move and the plane of focus will be off, so we never get it quite as sharp or in focus as if you did it like the right way and just focused on that spot. You know, you can even use the outer focus points to reduce the distance of where you're moving the frame, but depending on if those outer focus points are cross type in both directions, they may not be as accurate compared to the center point, so that does play into it as well. And your third option, which is pretty much just like a mirrorless camera, would be using live view and focusing everywhere, because generally with live view, you could focus across the entire frame. The same is said for a mirrorless camera. So with a mirrorless camera, with most of them, you can focus usually 80% horizontally and 100% vertically across the frame. I believe with the R5 now, you can even do 100% across the entire frame. That's how much they have advanced now. So why limit yourself to that small focus point? And you know, with a DSLR, depending on what level of camera you get is where you can focus. Whereas, you know, at the minimum, say you get like pick up an old camera like mine, the M3, M5, the small entry level mirrorless cameras for Canon, you can still focus 80% horizontally, which is amazing. Now it's 100%, that 20% difference. Whereas on the DSLR, the difference between the minimum and the maximum and how much you can focus is a lot larger compared to what it is with mirrorless cameras now, because they're reading directly off the sensor. Now, reason number three would be that you're buying newer and more future-proof technology. So as you know, with Nikon, their new mount is the Z mount. With Canon, their new mount is the RF mount. That's their mirrorless mounts, their newest thing. I don't believe Canon or Nikon have officially made a statement, but Canon have said that they will only make lenses for RF mount from now on. So obviously, if you're buying an EF body or a DSLR, you're buying into a system that is, you know, eventually not going to be supported anymore. I know with some stuff, like say phones, I know Apple, when it gets to a certain point, they stop releasing firmware updates for older phones and that sort of thing. Whether Canon will do something similar in the sense of will no longer service these cameras after a certain period, will only service RF, I don't think they would do it. I don't know if they would. I'm sure it would get a lot of backlash if they did do that, but that is something they may do, or Nikon may do. Some of the newer gear, obviously because it's new RF and that, may cost a lot more compared to the EF options, but you know, you buy once, you cry once. You buy it, you spend the money, but then you have that's future proof. It's unlikely to be outdated for a long time. If you look at a lens like the RF 85mm f1.2, there's very little like to complain about that lens. The only thing that they could really improve on that lens would be the size and the weight as new technology comes out. But as we know, it's all just a guessing game. Until that new technology comes out, you don't know what the advantage of it will be and how it would help. So it's not really something you could say it will definitely benefit over time or not. And in saying that, I always feel Nikon doesn't have a niche. You know, Sony's been known for their sensors, Canon known for the lenses. With Nikon, they, as I mentioned prior, they do have nice ergonomics, but continuing to make DSLRs and support them could actually be their niche. There is a huge market of people out there that only want to use DSLRs and refuse to go to mirrorless, even though this topic is why you should. If you are one of those people, Nikon should be making bodies, continue to make DSLRs, continue to make lenses just for that system. I'm sure they could actually get a lot of people to switch over, and they probably see some better growth in that sense, because they're the only one that will offer that aside from Pentax for quite some time to be. So the fourth reason as to why you should get a mirrorless would also be that older lenses do perform better. Now, despite using it across different systems, for example, my Canon EF 35mm F2IS, that was my favorite lens, but there was something just always off about it when I used it on DSLR. I'd do AFMA, which is autofocus micro adjust, to make sure it communicated better with the sensor and the body. I would do that, it would perform really well, tack sharp, but you find over time it would just seem to drift and not perform as well, and I'd have to constantly do it. Once I switched to Sony and I was using it on mirrorless, and the same would be said if you use it on Canon, EOS R, whatever, it performed so much better. The focus was more accurate, the focus was better. If you look online, people, you hear them using the old Canon EF 85mm f1.2. Using it on a mirrorless system brings new life into it because it works so much better. Because rather than the lens communicating with the mirror and the mirror communicating with the sensor, the lens is communicating directly with the sensor. So you're getting a much better communication between the two, and you'll find the focus is a lot more accurate and better, and you'll get less soft shots and that kind of stuff. And even with some older lenses, you can use manual focus with focus peaking, so you can actually see what is in focus through the viewfinder. Depending on which brand you're using, like Canon has a little meter that comes up that shows you when it's in focus. It's a bit hard to describe over a podcast, but lines will line up to be vertical or straightly horizontal once everything is in focus. Whereas with Sony, you'll have red, or you can choose the color, what color will be highlighting the parts that are in focus. I'm not too sure with Nikon. I believe their peaking is just like Sony's. And fact is, if you're using the same brand, so if you have an EOS R, R5, R6, or a Nikon Z6, Z7, and you're using their adapter, you know, some people say adapters don't work as well, but they work just like native. Because you got to remember, with something like Metabones MC11, this is a third-party company doing all the work, doing all the translating and that. Whereas with the Canon adapters and the Nikon adapters, they're making that themselves, so they know exactly how their lenses work, their bodies work, and can make it work just like native, just like it would as if you were plugging the lens directly on without an adapter. So there's no real downside aside from the slight little increase you get in size from that adapter, and the weight is usually less than 100 grams, so that's not even really a factor either. The fifth and final reason as to why you should go mirrorless is more advanced technology and autofocus. So because the sensor is communicating directly, With the lens, normal mirror, you have options like IAF. People think, but you know, you could focus on it before, but it's so much better being able to just hit a button. It focuses on the eyes and you can easily just, you know, focus on your composition, your exposure, whatever. You can look at everything else except for that and not have to worry about that. The tracking is a lot better as well in compared to a DSLR. So my shooting style may not have been the best back in DSLR, but I used to use AFS, so single shot, a lot more in a DSLR, whereas in mirrorless, especially for Sony, they're more designed to be used in AFC and have continuous AF. It does work well, and I find I have a lot more keepers. With a DSLR, I would always have the issue of, you know, this shot is out of focus. Say I take 10 shots, so many of them would be out of focus, slightly off. Whereas with mirrorless, I never really get that option. It's more my own problem now. If I find an image is not a keeper, it's not a case of, oh, you know, focus was off or this was off, the exposure was off. It's more just my composition was bad. I didn't like this composition as much as the other one. Or my framing, you know, wasn't as bad, that, or my distance to the subject wasn't as good. It's more creative issues, not technical issues. The mirrorless and the better autofocus does get rid of that. One thing I hated about DSLR was having to do AFMA. So with autofocus micro adjust, you would adjust it in the camera. So the mirror, I believe it was a mirror, or the focusing screen would move forward or backward. So that way, if your lens was front focusing, it would correct that. Or, you know, back focusing would do the same. With mirrorless, you don't need to do that anymore. It's so much better. It's so less hassle, less troublesome. That's one of the other reasons I would never ever go back to using a DSLR. In all honesty, I wouldn't mind owning a DSLR just as something that, you know, is memorabilia sake. Like, oh, this is something, you know, old technology kind of thing. Like people own film cameras just for the fun of it. For me, I think of DSLRs just like that now. One thing you'll notice I didn't really go into in a specific sense is brand, size, and weight. Because number one, with brand, it doesn't matter. No matter which camera brand you get, it's what suits you and what's best for you and what lenses you want. Who cares what badge it is? Sony, Nikon, Canon. Forget all the fanboy stuff, Flame Wars. Who cares? It's all about what you want to shoot and maybe be able to create your art. And the other thing is size and weight. People I've talked to have thought that, you know, oh, the only advantage to mirrorless is size and weight. No, they're pretty much the same size as a DSLR, if not bigger and heavier sometimes, especially for the Panasonic ones. Size and weight is not a thing. They're long past those days now where size and weight is the advantage to mirrorless. Maybe for lenses, yes, but not for actual bodies themselves. So forget about that. Those aren't even benefits to it. It's just what it is. So I hope you enjoyed this. I hope this did help you. If you were sort of wondering if there's any benefits to moving to mirrorless and, you know, whether it's your first camera or your last camera or your next camera, if it is your first camera, I would highly recommend a mirrorless, just because it's going to make that learning stage a lot easier. Whereas if it is your next camera, it may seem not as appealing, maybe a bit scary moving to a different system, different technology, leaving something you've loved and used for a long time behind, but it is worth the jump. If you do have any questions in further, you can ask me, reach out to me on Twitter, reach out to me on Flickr, that sort of stuff. I'm easy to reach, or even from my website, photosbydlee.com. But I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you.